Inbreeding is the practice of marrying within a closed group or community, and it has had a long and troubling history. From ancient Egypt to European monarchies, those in power sought to preserve lineages and consolidate alliances through inbreeding, often at the expense of genetic diversity. Inbreeding within royal families, such as the Habsburgs and the British royalty, resulted in physical and mental health problems and even power struggles. In this video, we will explore the genetic consequences of inbreeding in isolated communities, such as Tristan da Cunha and the Fundamentalist Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, FLDS, where limited genetic variation led to higher rates of genetic disorders. However, advances in genetic testing, counseling, and education offer hope for mitigating the risks associated with inbreeding and protecting the health and survival of affected populations. The video concludes by celebrating the power of genetic science to understand our past and shape a healthier future for all. Echoes through time. The intricate dance of inbreeding. Inbreeding is a practice that has woven its sinister thread throughout the centuries. From the royal houses of Europe to the ancient pharaohs of Egypt, those in positions of power have engaged in this biologically risky practice, seeking to preserve pure bloodlines, consolidate power, and control alliances. However, as Charles Darwin wisely observed, nature insists on diversity, and while inbreeding may solidify power in the short term, it is ultimately a dangerous bet against the persistence of diversity. Join us as we uncover the tragic stories and far-reaching consequences of inbreeding throughout history. Whispers from the sands of time, the pharaonic dance of lineages. Historically, there has been a tradition of marriage between relatives in ancient Egypt and the Habsburg dynasty of Europe. In ancient Egypt, the practice of mixed marriages among rulers aimed to preserve lineage purity and consolidate power. Pharaohs like Ptolemy II and Cleopatra VII married their siblings, believing these unions were divinely sanctioned by the gods Isis and Osiris. However, this practice had its consequences, as seen in the health problems and complications experienced by pharaohs like Tutankhamun. Similarly, the Habsburg dynasty in Europe sought to maintain power within the family through intermarriage, resulting in physical and mental health issues, most notably the Habsburg jaw. These examples serve as a stark reminder of the adverse effects of inbreeding and the risks associated with preserving power at the expense of genetic diversity. The lion and the unicorn. Intertwined lineages of the British monarchy. Charles II's inability to produce an heir due to generations of inbreeding led to a power vacuum and the War of the Spanish Succession. Similarly, in the British royal family, marriages between close relatives were common in medieval times to consolidate power and preserve alliances. Queen Victoria's descendants married members of various European royal houses, establishing a network of interconnected relationships. However, this practice had consequences, as genetic disorders like haemophilia were passed down through generations. As society's understanding of genetics evolved, the tradition of marrying close relatives in the British royal family began to wane. The video highlights how inbreeding has left a lasting impact on human genetics, resulting in various genetic and health consequences throughout history. The study of genetics has shed light on the risks associated with reducing genetic diversity caused by inbreeding. The puzzle of genetic inheritance. Inbreeding brings genetic implications and can lead to a higher incidence of genetic disorders. The concept of the coefficient of inbreeding, developed by statistician and geneticist Sir Ronald Fisher, is presented as a measure to assess the risks associated with inbreeding. The video mentions the example of Pingalap Island in Micronesia, where the isolated population experiences a high prevalence of a rare genetic condition called achromatopsia. However, the availability of genetic counseling and testing has provided hope for mitigating the risks associated with inbreeding. The video also explores how inbreeding is not limited to human societies, but is also observed in certain animal species as a survival strategy. The complex dynamics of inbreeding are highlighted through examples like the endangered Florida panther and the isolated population of Galapagos hawks. Overall, the video emphasizes the importance of understanding and addressing the genetic consequences of inbreeding to protect the health and survival of affected populations. Silent echoes, genetic ripples in isolated human communities. Tristan da Cunha, an isolated island in the South Atlantic, illustrates how geographical isolation can lead to a tightly knit community with limited genetic variation. The population of Tristan da Cunha has faced challenges related to hereditary disorders, such as retinitis pigmentosa, due to their limited genetic pool. Another example of inbreeding resulting from cultural isolation is seen in the Fundamentalist Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, FLDS. The practice of polygamy and strict cultural beliefs led a significant portion of the group to trace their ancestry back to a few ancestors, resulting in a higher incidence of rare genetic disorders. Despite these challenges, both communities exhibit resilience and unity. Advances in genetic understanding and the availability of tools such as genetic testing and counseling have played a crucial role in mitigating the consequences of inbreeding, providing ways to predict and prevent adverse health outcomes resulting from limited genetic variation. Genetic guardians, modern tools that shield us from inbreeding. Throughout history, science has developed genetic testing and genetic counseling to combat the effects of inbreeding. By using genetic testing and confidential matching services, the program has significantly reduced the occurrence of genetic diseases, demonstrating the potential of genetic testing to address the challenges posed by inbreeding. Genetic counselors play a crucial role in helping individuals and families understand and navigate the implications of genetic disorders. They assess the risk of a couple having a child with a genetic condition and provide guidance on how to manage these risks. A pioneer in this field was Sheldon Reed, who coined the term genetic counseling in the 1940s. His philosophy was to empower individuals to make informed decisions about their genetic health, a principle that still guides the profession today. The advent of these genetic tools offers not only a scientific triumph, but also a beacon of hope for those grappling with the specter of inbreeding. These tools shed light on the shadows of our genetic makeup, allowing us to navigate the intricate dance of inheritance with more confidence. How laws shape the landscape of inbreeding. There are laws and regulations related to inbreeding that are intricately woven into the complex tapestry of social norms, ethics, and principles of health and well-being. In various parts of the world, there are laws prohibiting close relatives from marrying, primarily due to the risk of adverse genetic outcomes. The United States, for example, has a complex mosaic of laws that vary from state to state. Some states allow first cousins to marry, while others strictly prohibit it. South Korea, on the other hand, had an old law known as the Same Surname and Origin Clause, which prohibited marriage between people with the same surname and ancestral domicile, regardless of their degree of kinship. While initially designed to prevent inbreeding, the law eventually came under scrutiny due to its restrictive nature and was abolished after much social debate. The video also mentions the historic legal case of the Haldane sisters in England in 1935, highlighting the deep discussion on genetics, inbreeding, and the law that ensued. In Brazil, there is a unique approach to combating inbreeding in the isolated community of Canudos. Instead of using legal measures, health officials introduced a program called the Family Health Program, which used education about genetic risks to reduce inbreeding. By 2005, a significant decrease in consanguineous marriages was observed, demonstrating the potential of education as an alternative to legal restrictions. Echoes from the past, unraveling the tapestry of genetic disorders in consanguineous populations. It is important to examine the impact of inbreeding on genetic disorders in certain populations. Two specific disorders, cystic fibrosis and thalassemia, have been prevalent in populations with high levels of inbreeding. Cystic fibrosis, a potentially life-threatening genetic disease, was believed to have originated around 3000 BCE and provided a survival advantage during cholera outbreaks. Thalassemia, characterized by abnormal hemoglobin production, was once a survival mechanism against malaria, but has now become a burden in the absence of the disease. The isolation of island communities has also led to the prevalence of unique genetic disorders, such as complete achromatopsia on Pingalap Island. However, modern science has brought hope through the development of gene therapy, offering potential treatment for these conditions. Strategies such as pre-implantation genetic diagnosis have also been developed to prevent the transmission of genetic disorders. Additionally, the section explores the intricate dance of managing breeding practices in zoos and conservation programs to combat inbreeding and promote genetic diversity. The delicate dance of diversity, inbreeding challenges in zoos and conservation programs. The American Association of Zoos and Aquariums launched the Species Survival Plan in 1981 to ensure genetic variability among populations of endangered species, such as lowland gorillas. While these efforts have been successful, challenges persist in wildlife conservation. as evidenced by the decline of the Florida panther population in the 1990s. Interwoven lineages, depictions of inbreeding in the realm of fiction and media. There are several representations of inbreeding in fiction and media. The Lannister family in the series Game of Thrones serves as a fascinating study of aristocratic inbreeding, with Cersei and Jaime Lannister maintaining a clandestine relationship as twins born into one of the most powerful families in the Seven Kingdoms. The Netflix series The Crown subtly addresses the implications of maintaining royal bloodlines, and the Spanish film Los Sin Nombre explores the sinister potential of inbreeding when misguided ideologies dictate social norms. The video also mentions the Japanese manga series Koi Kaze, which delves into the social and emotional implications of a romantic relationship between siblings. Through these examples, the speaker emphasizes the complex nature of inbreeding and its genetic implications. Some of the risks of inbreeding include higher risk of birth defects, higher risk of genetic diseases, higher risk of early death, lower intelligence, higher likelihood of behavioral problems. Inbreeding can also have a negative impact on the health of the population as a whole. This is because inbreeding can reduce genetic diversity, making the population more vulnerable to diseases.